The most interesting cloud developments over the first half of 2018 all revolve around software as a service, but IoT, AI, and machine learning are still change makers. For TechRepublic and ZDNet, I'm Dan Patterson with Larry Dignan and Bill Detwiler. Larry, you have a great list of six big reasons the cloud is changing business tech in 2018. What have we learned so far?
Yeah, this is kind of a follow-on to what we did ranking the top cloud vendors for 2018 at the beginning of the year. And what we've seen since is that the field's narrowed really dramatically. And you see this in Gartner's Magic Quadrant, where basically they took a field of almost, it was like 20 vendors and whittled it down to six. So in something like infrastructure as service, the big three leaders were Amazon Web Services, Microsoft Azure, and Google Cloud. And then they had Alibaba, Oracle, and IBM. Everybody else got chucked. So it was pretty interesting where they just basically, I mean, we always thought of it like a big three, big four sort of field. And Gartner just sort of confirmed that. So that's interesting because just the field is basically narrowed down dramatically. Into what we were talking about just like a year ago.
So Bill, I know that we have some additional research from the TechPro Research Hybrid Cloud Report. Anything interesting from here that kind of dovetails with what Larry has learned?
Yeah, definitely. You know, what we saw when we released this report last year were the same results. We saw Microsoft at the top, followed by Amazon, and that really depends on your survey size and the sample that you're getting. So it was Microsoft, Amazon, Google in third place, and then everyone else, whether it's IBM, whether it's Cisco, further down the line. So what's really interesting, and that what dovetails into what Larry was saying, is that when we asked people about which vendors they were considering in 2016, and then we asked the question again in 2017, what we found is there was a big jump in Amazon's numbers, a significant jump, compared to Microsoft stayed about the same, and Google actually had a slight decline from 2016 to 2017.
Larry, the old adage, developers, 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 remains true. How are Microsoft and Google making a pitch to developers to work on their cloud platforms?
Well, we saw a lot of this with their two respective shows. So Microsoft had Build, Google had I/O. Both talked extensively about AI. So they're all seeing AI, their AI technology being delivered by cloud platforms. And that seems to be resonating when you're talking about IoT, AI, machine learning, and you know how that all plays into digital transformation. So both Microsoft and AWS are really making those pushes. It's very interesting because you know AWS released DeepLens, which is sort of this machine learning camera, which is it's basically a toy for developers to start playing with machine learning on the edge. So that's very interesting development. And then you know let's not forget Microsoft went out and bought GitHub. Which you know doesn't necessarily play into the cloud, but you can see they want to be a developer resource, and GitHub plays into that extensively.
The cloud is still very profitable. When we look into the next two quarters of 2018 and Q1 2019, what is likely to change or shift here, or is this going to be business as usual?
For me, what's going to be most interesting to watch is to watch how AWS accelerates, right? Because their revenue run rate just keeps snowballing. Microsoft Azure, I would love to get more data on that. Right now, Microsoft puts something in called the commercial cloud, which is Office 365, a few other things, and Azure. And I'd love to see Azure broken out into its own thing, because then you could pit Azure versus AWS, with right now we can't do that. And then the other thing is just, you know, Google combines, they gave $1 billion cloud run rate like two quarters ago. But the weird thing there, it's very much like Microsoft. It's G Suite plus Google Cloud Platform. So what I'm hoping happens in the second half of 2018 is just, we just get a lot more transparency on these cloud revenues, because right now, AWS is most transparent. Oracle's just as transparent. They break things down pretty nicely. Alibaba Cloud breaks out things out pretty well. But generally speaking, it's hard to have, you know, a correct bake-off to see who's the biggest dog on the block. For instance, IBM, they have a cloud revenue statistic, which includes, you know, hybrid stuff. It includes as a service revenue. It also includes some hardware here and there. So I usually track their as a service revenue. But as this goes on, I expect these businesses to scale more, and then we'll get more visibility. But right now, it's, you know, it's clearly in AWS and Azure, you know, race in terms of revenue.
All right, you can read all of the takeaways from the Cloud Wars 2018 by visiting ZDNet and looking for Cloud Wars, 6 things we learned in the first half. We have similar stories, including the new hybrid cloud report on Tech Pro Research. Both sites have PDFs, ebook downloads, and tons of other data and important takeaways for business tech professionals. For ZDNet and Tech Republic, I'm Dan Patterson.